My name is Catherine Hayhoe. I'm a climate scientist. I'm a professor at Texas Tech University, and I'm also chief scientist for the Nature Conservancy, which is a global organization that works on climate change, biodiversity, and conservation in 76 countries, including in Europe. Being a climate scientist is not easy. For telling the truth, you get a lot of hate, many attacks, every day. And what we study is depressing and scary. It makes you feel anxious and worried. Some days I think it would be easier if I was studying astrophysics. But it's more important to study climate change, because if we don't fix climate change, we can't fix anything else. I agree that the vision that we see most often of the future is a negative one. If we don't do everything we can to tackle climate change, our future will be worse. That's true. But what we are missing is we are missing a vision of what the positive future would look like if we did address climate change, of how clean our air would be, of how abundant our water and our food would be, how walkable our cities, how green our world. That's what we want to head towards. And that is very important because our human brains are wired to move forward towards a reward, not to avoid harm. And so when we use fear and fear alone as a message, that can wake people up. But if they don't know what to do, it paralyzes them. Fear will ultimately paralyze us unless we know where to go. And in order to know where to go, we need that vision of a better future. And that is probably the most important thing that we are missing in our public discourse today. So often, when we talk about climate change, people feel hopeless, afraid, frustrated, sad, angry, overwhelmed. And no wonder, because we do everything we can to help. We recycle, we take the train, we eat less meat. And then we hear that there's 3,000 empty flights that the airline is flying just to keep their gate assignments. Or that the 1% richest people in the world produce the most emissions. And we think, what difference can I make? And then we feel despair. But we can make a difference. And that difference begins by understanding that we have to change the system, but a system is made up of people. And how does a system change when people call for that change? So yes, we can do things in our personal life, but the single most important thing that every one of us can do is talk about it. Not the science, not the polar bears, not the ice sheets. Talk about why it matters here. How is climate change affecting us? It's making floods worse. It's making springs drier. It's making summer heat more intense. Sea levels rising. And that is affecting people's lives right here, not only on the other side of the world. So we need to talk about how it matters to us here, but we also need to talk about what solutions look like for our city, for our school, for our church, for the organization where we work, or our company. Every organization at every level needs to change, and the way we change is when people use their voice to call for action. That's the only way that our society has ever changed before, and it's the way it must change again. And that means that it begins with us. I'm a climate scientist because I'm a Christian. As a student, I was studying astronomy and physics. I wanted to be an astrophysicist. But I needed an extra class to finish my undergraduate degree, and there was a brand new class on climate change in the geography department. So I thought, well, that looks interesting. Why not take it? I knew that climate change was real, but I thought that it was still a future issue, one that environmentalists would take care of whenever it became a problem. But in that class, I learned that climate change is very urgent. It is affecting us here and now in ways that matter to all of us. And even though climate change affects us all, it doesn't affect us all equally. The poorest people, the most vulnerable people, the marginalized people, right here, as well as on the other side of the world, they are the ones who are most affected by climate change, and that's not fair. As a Christian, I believe that we are to love others as we have been loved by God. In fact, Jesus says in the Gospel of John that Christians are to be known or recognized by their love for others. And at its core, climate change is a failure to love. So I thought to myself, how can I not do everything I can to help with this problem? Because in helping this problem, we are loving our sisters and our brothers, and we are loving and caring for and taking responsibility over every living thing on this planet, as God called us to in Genesis 1. So as a Christian, I believe that if we truly take the Bible seriously, we will be out at the front of the line demanding climate action. Often people ask, what can we do at my church? And with a church, with a community, there are so many different things we can do. First of all, we can teach about it. That is the role of a church, to teach people. What does the Bible say and how do we live according to what we believe? Then we can change things at the church itself, at the building itself. Maybe solar panels, maybe a community garden, maybe an energy audit, maybe looking at the type of food that you serve. Then you can change things with the lives of people who attend the church, helping them make changes, have conversations, make a difference where they live and where they work. Churches can also work in the community in which they are in, because there are always people around you in the community who might be affected if there's a flood or drought or heat wave, or they might want to know what to do and they don't know, so you could help them understand as well. And then there are many organizations working around the world with some of the poorest people in the world, helping them prepare for the impacts of climate change, or providing them with clean sources of energy when they have no energy at all. So we can learn about those organizations, we can support those organizations, we can even invite people from those organizations to speak to our church. Everybody can talk on Zoom these days. And we can learn more about what they're doing, and then we can tell other people about what they're doing as well. So at a church, there are so many different layers of things that we can do. The most important thing an individual can do is not be such an individual. What is much more important than our personal choices is the choice of the whole school, or the whole university, or the whole business, or the whole church, or the whole city. As an individual, the way we change the system, the very first step is by using our voice.